Welcome to the worship from Daleville Christian Church. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you in this time in His Word for the blessing you may be in His name to others. We have an affirmation of faith for each Sunday from God's Word, this one from the letter of 2 Thessalonians in the second chapter. We ought always to thank God for you, brothers and sisters, loved by the Lord, because God chose you as first fruits to be saved through the sanctifying work of the Holy Spirit and through belief in the truth. He called you to this through our gospel, that you might share in the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. The reading of God's word for today is from the letter of 1 Corinthians in the third chapter, verses 3 through 9. Since there is jealousy and quarreling among you, are you not worldly? Are you not acting like mere mortals? For when one says, I follow Paul, and another, I follow Apollos, are you not merely human beings? What, after all, is Apollos? And what is Paul? Only servants, through whom you came to believe, as the Lord has assigned to each his task. I planted the seed, Apollos watered it, but God made it grow. So neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything, but only God who makes things grow. The one who plants and the one who waters have one purpose, and each one will be rewarded according to his own labor. For we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field, God's building. May the Lord add his blessing to this reading of his holy word. The message for today is quite pointed, as it involves Daleville Christian Church in particular. But wherever you are listening from, I believe there is blessing in our review of God's Word for today. This is Pastor Appreciation Month, and we have much to discuss. Usually, I'm not terribly excited about Pastor Appreciation Month, and I'll explain that sometime this month. But this year, I'm looking forward to Pastor Appreciation Month. Here's the short answer. Pastor appreciation is biblical, and we should never forget that. This year, I have a number of personal anniversaries. Although my anniversaries are personal, they involve you, Daleville Christian Church. And we are going to talk about a topic that I've been thinking about and a topic you need to begin thinking about. That topic is my retirement. Someday, I'm not going to be here anymore. One of the dates for me not being here anymore is on the calendar, July 1st, 2024. My last sermon here is scheduled for June 30th, 2024. Why do you need to know that now? Why am I not waiting to give you 2 weeks' notice or 1 month notice like my service agreements with you state? There are two reasons for us to do this. First of all, a friend of mine has begged me to give you plenty of time to think and plan about my leave-taking. And as the elders with me have discussed, and I will mention in the upcoming sermons, some of the congregation's financial planning for my replacement needs to begin now. The second reason that you need this time to prepare for my leave-taking is that many of you have never worked on replacing and calling a new pastor. I could name many people who joined this church and passed away in this church while I was their pastor. They never had to work to find and hire another pastor. Some of you have never had to work to find another pastor. Some of you may feel that you still don't want to work to find another pastor. That's a natural feeling. But I remind you that my leave-taking is on the calendar. And as I joked with the elders, we are in a worldwide pandemic. I am a human being. One way or another, someday I will leave this congregation. Rather than wait for the need to hire and find another pastor, it's way better to plan ahead of time on how to find and hire another pastor. This month, we'll talk about ministry today in the United States. We will talk about churches in the United States. We'll talk about churches in this state. We'll talk about things you and I want to avoid when hiring a new pastor. We will talk about things we can look forward to in hiring a new pastor. And some really good news is right here in Daleville Christian Church, in Daleville. Let me briefly remind you, Daleville Christian Church had the same daycare director for over 40 years in Mrs. Sells. She wanted to retire. We had some difficulty finding candidates at first. Later, we found one. He didn't last but 1 year, and then we found another one, a better one, in our present Cindy Hale. So we have some experience right here in Daleville Christian Church. Daleville Community Schools just formally retired Paul Garrison, superintendent, for over 30 years. I met the new superintendent last week, Mr. Greg Roach. This church and this community have made these transitions successfully. There's every reason to believe that you, Daleville Christian Church, can manage this coming transition also. In addition, your elders have been studying this book called Succession, about the congregation's next pastor. We, you, Daleville Christian Church, are already taking the first step this author says is essential to a successful succession for the next lead pastor of Daleville Christian Church. The essential first step is planning for that transition to happen. We are, in part, and right now, during pastor appreciation, we are planning for that transition. However, we must face the reality that this transition will not be a walk in the park. The system for finding the next pastor at Daleville Christian Church does not exist for us. All through the 20th century, Daleville Christian Church called the state office. They sent us candidates' papers. The pulpit committee reviewed them, found one to interview, and went from there. If none was found, repeat the process. All denominations have their own process. Non-denominational churches don't have those processes. It is of interest to note that Wikipedia says the first non-denominational churches in America were the Christian churches and the churches of Christ and the Christian church disciples of Christ. That is our foundation. Also, if we would number non-denominational churches and they were their own denomination, they would be the third largest denomination in the United States. So, Daleville Christian Church, you have plenty of company when it comes to the time of finding and hiring a new pastor. So these are very good reasons to talk now about the clergy, your future pastor. the future Daleville Christian Church, the state of the clergy in this country, and the state of the Protestant churches in this country. Also, the state of our own communities in our state, which are even now having trouble securing new pastors, just as they are having trouble finding enough teachers for our public schools. The Bible itself gives examples of transitions that were not planned or not planned well. The Bible warns us, don't do that. Get everyone on the same page, or we could say, get everyone on the same page of the hymnal so when we start singing together, we sound good. Simply put, I've been planning my retirement for a couple of years. Now Daleville Christian Church should be planning for my retirement for the next 2 years. In the coming weeks, we will discuss some problems unique to Daleville Christian Church and problems unique to our communities, problems that provide challenges for securing a new pastor. One of my brother-in-laws, is it brother-in-laws or brothers-in-law, told me that my leave-taking is not my problem. It's your problem. I can appreciate my brother-in-law's viewpoint, Daleville Christian Church. However, I have been here at Daleville Christian Church for over 30 years. It would be callous and even unchristian to think or say that I have nothing to do with my own leave-taking of Daleville Christian Church. What was a Bible verse we looked at just a few weeks ago? Philippians 2:4. Let each of you look not only to his own interests, but also to the interests of others. Jesus certainly prepared the disciples for Jesus' own leave-taking. And Jesus prepared the disciples twice. Jesus tried to prepare the disciples for his leave-taking to go to his crucifixion at Golgotha. And then Jesus prepared the disciples for his leave-taking from this earth. Jesus was only with the disciples 3 years. I've been lead pastor for over 30 years. Should I just walk away from you and say goodbye? Jesus didn't do that after just 3 years of teaching. Should I do differently from Jesus after 30 years? I want to help you, and I intend to help you with my leave-taking. As Groucho Marx once sang, "Hello, I must be going. I cannot stay, I came to say, I must be going." Wanting to help you with my leave-taking is a part of my whole life of service for Jesus' church. I have always wanted to help Jesus' church. Somewhere in my 3 years at seminary, and remember that was 40 years ago when you were young, the class was encouraged to write down what you thought, what you wanted to accomplish as a minister, as a pastor. I don't recall that we turned in that assignment, and remember those were the days when you didn't save things on your computer because there were no computers, at least no personal computers. The reason for the assignment was this: years after you, the seminary student, had been in church work, get that old paper out and review it. Have you accomplished anything you set out to do? Have you changed what you think you are to accomplish as a pastor? I think that if I could find that assignment from seminary, that part of that naive paper would still be the same. I want to help Jesus' church. The Apostle Paul wanted to help the churches in the Greek city of Corinth. We have at least two of Paul's letters to those Corinthian churches in our Bibles. The Apostle Paul was one of the founding pastors of the Corinthian churches, and it is said he was present in that city for about a year and a half. His letters were written after he had left Corinth, and the ones we have they say, are 3 to 4 years after his time there. Paul is distressed about what he hears concerning the church. 1 Corinthians 1:11. My brothers and sisters, some from close household have informed me that there are quarrels among you. What I mean is, one says, I follow Paul. Another, I follow Apollos. Another, I follow Cephas. Still another, I follow Christ. Rather than a unity that Paul makes plain in Paul's letters for Jesus' churches, the apostle discovers that there is division. We might understand this problem better if we say it this way. Paul discovered that the Corinthian congregation contained both Republicans and Democrats. Rather than the unity of the people being united as Americans, as we should be in our country, Paul discovers not the unity of Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, but quarrels, division. The apostle just straight out asks them, is Christ divided? For when one says, I belong to Paul, and another, I belong to Apollos, what is Apollos? What is Paul? Servants through whom you believed as the Lord assigned to each. I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the growth. So, neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything. Neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything. But only God gives the growth. He who plants and he who waters are equal, and each shall receive his wages according to his labor. For we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field, God's building. The unity of Jesus' church is a basic teaching of the Apostle Paul's, and the Corinthian churches and the churches of Rome were especially having a tough time with the reality of unity. For Paul, it's this simple. There is one Jesus Christ. There is one Holy Spirit. Therefore, those who are of the Holy Spirit through Jesus Christ are one, united. So there it is in our Bibles. Church people will make themselves fans and followers of their leaders. I follow Apollos. I follow Paul. I follow Cephas. And the apostle says, don't do that. I heard it said that if a pastor stays too long in a church, the church becomes a personality cult. God forbid it. I don't want any fans. Jesus didn't want any fans. Jesus wanted followers. I want Jesus to have followers. I want you to follow Jesus, not me. And that's doubly true after I am gone. A pastor friend and I have a favorite film, the 1960s comedy, Support Your Local Sheriff. If you've never seen the film, you should. It stars the late great actor James Garner. Basically, what happens is that James Garner's character ambles into the American Western frontier town. The town leaders want to hire him as sheriff since he demonstrated that he was good with a gun. Garner's character has never been a sheriff and wasn't sure he even wanted the job. Throughout the film, Garner's character will say, "Now, I've never made secret of the fact that basically I'm on my way to Australia." Friends, ever since the Second Great Awakening in this country, which is how most American churches got started, American pastors have been itinerants, going from place to place. The fact that I have remained here for 30 plus years doesn't really change that fact. I'm still an itinerant, and now we know when I hope to be moving on. There's no real reason to try to hang on to me here or keep me here since I'm not going to another church. As you might remember, because I have told you, I came to Daleville not because I planned or wanted to, right? When I came to Daleville, Daleville was not shown on all state maps. That was back when all maps were on paper. I came here because I had prayed that day that I would go anywhere the Lord wanted me to go. Daleville Christian Church reached me by phone later that same day. That was back when the telephone was attached to the wall and not attached to our hands. But friends, I've never made secret of the fact that basically I'm on my way to Australia. Before I leave in a couple of years, and while I'm gone, and after I am gone, you want to remember that we are all of the same Holy Spirit. We sang last week, the church's one foundation, second verse, elect from every nation, yet one o'er all the earth, her charter of salvation, one Lord, one faith, one birth. One holy name she blesses, partakes one holy food, and to one hope she presses, with every grace endued. You may not like the fact that someday I'll be gone. You may not be happy about it. I would like you to be happy about the future of this church and its ongoing mission. Daleville Christian Church is supposed to be Jesus's church, not mine. I want you to be a part of Jesus's church, no matter who the lead pastor at Daleville Christian Church is. In the coming weeks, we will talk about finding a pastor for the ongoing mission of Daleville Christian Church. The Apostle Paul's reminder to the churches in Corinth. What then is Apollos? What is Paul? Servants through whom you believed as the Lord assigned to each. Neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. For we are fellow workers. You are God's field. You are God's building.